That voice is back. And the Prophet is also back. They rushed to the masjid and they found Sayyiduna Bilal saying the adhan. They watched him until he reached Ashahadu, and he stopped. And he couldn't say the name of the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Sayyiduna Bilal radiyallahu anhu, he left Madinatul Munawwara and he went to live in the lands of Shaam after the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam left this world. Why? Because he couldn't bear walking on streets where he didn't see the Prophet. He couldn't bear praying in the masjid where he couldn't see the Prophet. He couldn't bear to live in that place where he used to meet the Prophet, greet the Prophet, embrace the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and the Prophet would pour all of his love unto Sayyiduna Bilal radiyallahu anhu. He lived in Ash-Sham for so long until one night he saw the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam in his dream. And the Prophet said, "Ma hadha al-jafa ya Bilal? Why this distance and this harshness, O Bilal? You haven't visited us for so long." Sayyiduna Bilal awoke and he rode his camel all the way to Madinatul Munawwara. When he entered into Medina and the people on the street saw him, they began to shout, "Bilal is here, Bilal is here." Because it was the voice of Bilal that reminded them of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. It was the voice of Bilal that used to reunite them at the feet of the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alaihi wasallam for the five daily prayers. When they saw Bilal coming back to Medina, they began to rush towards him in droves, meet him and greet him, because this lover of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam had come back. They asked him, "Bilal, please say that adhan just once that you used to say to unite us with the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam." But Bilal said, "I'm sorry, that's one thing I can't do. How can I say the adhan and mention the name of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam whilst I won't be seeing him when I say his blessed name sallallahu alaihi wasallam? Please excuse me." Until the blessed grandchildren, Sayyidun al-Hasan and Sayyidun al-Husayn of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, they requested and said, "Please say the adhan that you used to say in the days of our grandfather sallallahu alaihi wasallam, for your voice will remind us of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam." Sayyidun Bilal couldn't deny these two beautiful flowers of the house of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. So he walked up to the rooftop of where he used to say the adhan, and he began and he said, "Allahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar." Irtajjat al-Madinah. When he said those words, the city of Medina shook. Why? Because the people thought the Messenger of Allah has been sent again. The Messenger of Allah has been resurrected. They began to call, "Aborisa Rasulullah, has the Messenger of Allah been sent again?" They rushed from their homes. The men, the women, the elderly, the children, all rushed towards the direction of the masjid. Why? Because many years ago, it was this voice that used to unite them with the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. And years had passed, they hadn't heard this voice. Years had passed, they hadn't been united with their beloved sallallahu alaihi wasallam. They thought, perhaps that voice is back, and the Prophet is also back. They rushed to the masjid and they found Sayyiduna Bilal saying the adhan. They watched him until he reached Ashhadu, and he stopped. And he couldn't say the name of the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alaihi wasallam. He dropped to the ground because his love overwhelmed him. His yearning to see the blessed face of the Messenger of Allah overcame him. And he returned back to Shaam. My dear brothers and sisters, this is an example of love for the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alaihi wasallam. My dear brothers and sisters, this is an example of love whereby saying his name makes a person break down in emotion to see the personality behind the name, to want to unite with the one whose name is being uttered and being said and being pronounced. My dear brothers and sisters, we have to sit and remember the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, yearn to see him, to meet him, to visit him, to reunite with him, to increase in our love for him sallallahu alaihi wasallam. These types of thoughts must be going through our minds, must be juggling our hearts, and our tongues must become moist with salawat and durood sharif and sending peace and blessings upon him. Because the scholars have said, وَعَلَامَةُ مُحَبَّتِهِ كَسْرَةُ ذِكْرِهِ, and from the signs of his love is abundant remembrance of him. My dear brothers and sisters, let's illuminate our hearts and our homes and our lives with the remembrance of the Messenger of Allah, in hope that Allah will fill our hearts and increase our hearts with his love, with a burning, yearning state within our hearts, such that when we close our eyes, we gaze upon his noble countenance. Sallallahu alayhi wa alihi.